Welcome back to the HellfireComms Disneython. Today we're going to be watching a favourite of mine, actually. This is Ducktales, Treasure of the Lost Lamp. With me today, I have Darkened Razor and Mexican Bass Monkey. And Mexi, this was your pick, so shoot.
When I was a child, I watched cartoons. I watched a shit ton of cartoons, like an unhealthy amount. And most of the time was dedicated to watching Disney cartoons. Ducktales was one of my favorite. And I had the VHS for this movie. And I kid you not, I watched it so much, the tape ripped. I love DuckTales so much. It's partially the theme song, and it's partially just how silly and fun it is.
Was that actually from the DuckTales series? Because it reminds me a lot of the plane from Tailspin.
They carry that over a lot. I mean, Launchpad himself is in this and Darkwing Duck for reasons.
Ah, yes. Now, you will notice that the animation quality is actually quite high here. 5 minutes in, expect it to drop like a rock.
Well, they did get a new studio to do this. They had Movie Tunes. Of course, Movie Tunes no longer existed after this movie came out.
Well, at least they made one good thing, I guess.
Yep, shame it just wasn't financially successful.
What's your history with DuckTales, Drazer?
Woo.
Is that about it?
As a kid, I did not watch DuckTales. Around the time, I wasn't really into Disney cartoons. I was more into Cartoon Network.
Ah, okay.
So there were a few. I did watch Disney films, and there were a few things on Disney Channel I watched, but DuckTales just wasn't one of them. And I knew vaguely that this movie existed, so it's completely new to me. This entire thing is new to me.
I believe I watched this on like a sunny summer afternoon, and I was just entranced through the whole thing, really, because I'd always loved like Donald Duck and by extension Scrooge, because I had a few of the old comics. Not many, but a few of them. But yeah, I love the whole treasure hunting aspect, because obviously, as you know by now, I'm into shiny things quite heavily, and treasure hunting has always been something that appeals to me, so DuckTales is just the logical extension of it.
Woo.
Shut up.
Sorry.
Wow, look at all that history and architecture gone.
Scrooge don't care. He's just after that bank.
Scrooge's fucking rich. What's he gonna give a shit about?
I hate Launchpad so much. Every word out of his mouth makes me want to punch him in the bill.
So, who's the girl duck, by the way?
The girl is Webigail. She's the granddaughter of Scrooge's nanny, but eventually Scrooge adopted her as his great niece.
You say nanny, that just puts me in mind of Count Duckula. Do you remember that, Drazer?
Count Duckula, I think so. Oh my god.
I'd just like to point out that Drazer is actually Scottish.
I am. I'm from the very north of Scotland, and I want to point out to the viewers that us Scots do not talk like this, or act like this.
So you're not all money-grubbing mallards?
Well, maybe the money-grabbing bit, but we don't talk like Scrooge does, and the ducks that we have don't either.
Money-grubbing mallards, MGM for short.
Ah, a common misspelling of my name.
I was talking about the film studio as well.
Scrooge isn't the only thing that's moderately racist in this film. This is pre-9/11, so we can totally make fun of people who live in Muslim countries and depict them as essentially desert rats.
Yeah, this is like so weird going back and watching films from this time period. I'd also like to point out, this is a breath of fresh air watching this. We had just recently recorded Black Cauldron, and hoo-hoo boy, that was a bit of a boring time.
Oh god, that was so boring.
This will be a bit weird, because I think this will come before the Black Cauldron commentary, so oops, spoilers.
We just sequence broke in your marathon. Oh, baby! It's Christopher Lloyd, man!
That's a really odd name. I would have called him Darren the Dog or something.
No, that's the guy playing the villain, you dunce.
Yes, I know.
The character's name is Murloc.
Murloc?
Yep.
It's like Merlin and Warlock.
Yeah, let's just take those two and put them together.
And the snivy little thief is Dijon, like the mustard.
He's like Abysmal, except 10,000 times more pussyfied.
Talking of mustard, have you ever put too much mustard on a sandwich?
There is no such thing.
I don't partake of mustard.
When it comes to English mustard, Maxi, there is such thing.
Well, thank you for that interesting tidbit during this commentary on a children's film.
Quite. It's just so they learn, not to make the same mistake I once did.
It's weird seeing DuckTales characters animated so well with all the lighting and, like, proper limb movements and shit.
I love how this movie actually had work put into it. They very, very easy could have just, you know, made a really long episode of the show. But instead, you know, they made a movie.
A TV special, as it were.
Yup.
If they made a TV special, would we still be doing it for this? Because it wouldn't technically be a movie.
I still would probably go with this, since this is the movie.
Shiny green thing. Plus one. Okay, yeah, you can use it to transform into different animals. Cool.
See, he calls himself Murloc, which means he's a wizard and a warlock, but he's actually a druid.
Okay. Isn't Murloc actually from some of the DuckTales video games?
Yeah, they used him in two. Well, one is a DuckTales, one is a Mickey Mouse video game.
Uh-huh.
He was in the N64 DuckTales Going Quackers.
Uh-huh.
And then it was the, what was it, Castle of Illusion?
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Oh, Castle of Illusion.
No, not Castle, Legends! Legend of Illusion. They had too many Illusion games.
Was that on the Master System, or was that Land of Illusion?
Wait, there's even more? What?
Yeah, there's quite a few.
There's the ones I remember is there's Castle of Illusion, there's World of Illusion.
Love that shit.
Oh, I loved World of Illusion as a kid. And then there's now the two that you talk of, Land of Illusion and
Legend of Illusion, which was on Game Gear and Master System. That's what she said!
Oh, that's some efficient slave labor. What the fuck?
I know! Four ducks and a dog just did that.
Excuse me.
Don't do it, Drazer. Don't question it.
Instead, question how a bird can have facial hair on its beak.
No, he's a druid. That makes sense.
Well, even worse is that these guys are ducks, which is a bird, and he's a bird, but they're different tiers of birds.
Again, he's a druid. It makes sense.
Scrooge got that Zippo. Oh my god, that fire looks so bad! That is terrible fire!
Yeah, the animation's gonna start going downhill quite soon.
They should have took a page out of Black Cauldron and got, like, real fire.
Shut up, Dijon. You live in this country.
Yeah, just say that to the girl and have no regards for your actual kids. Or, well, sorry, nephews.
Grandnephews, actually.
Grandnephews, even better.
They're the sons of Donald's sister. And Scrooge is Donald's uncle.
Okay, I have never seen Donald's sister, ever.
Read the Life and Times of Scrooge McDuck, then.
You've never seen Debbie Duck?
No. But now that you've said the name, I've heard it before.
Don't you just love it in animation when the non-static item is totally highlighted?
Yep. Did either of you watch Quack Pack?
Yes.
I heard of it, never watched it.
It was pretty much DuckTales all grown up.
Yeah.
Only not as garbage. It was garbagey, but not as.
It was watchable.
I mean, it did kind of help give the boys more noticeable personality. Because if you watch DuckTales, it gets kind of hard to tell, like, who Huey, Dewey, and Louie are. But with Quack Pack, they, like, really differentiated the three.
Yeah, it's kind of like the Goof Troop version of the whole Ducktales mythos.
Oh man, I used to love this scene. Then again, when I was a kid, any scene that involved a slide, I just loved.
If it involved the slide, I was just like, oh my god, I want to go down that. Now watching that, I'd be like, no, I don't want to go down that, I'd probably die.
Fuck you, Marble!
That Marble be trolling.
Let's just slightly move the thing! Oh, there it is.
That was terribly animated.
And we're just over 10 minutes in, they found the treasure, credits roll. Bye, everyone!
Dun 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 dun. And don't worry, if you are watching the DVD release or whatever it is, you will hear that at the end.
Okay, seriously, Scrooge? You don't have to dive and swim into every monetary thing you find. You know, sometimes you can just squeeze it in your hands and feel it.
Also, it's not a liquid.
Actually, again, if you read The Life and Times of Scrooge McDuck, that's something only he can do.
Really? So he has magical powers now?
They don't specifically call it magic, per se.
Scrooge McDuck has the superpower of swimming in money. Wow. Even I didn't know that. That's hilarious. I am not touching! Oh my god, this institutionalized racism is so good.
Where he puts the rest of his treasure.
In the giant vault!
In that giant fuck-off vault.
Damn, it's like the ducks are doing the commentary for us.
I want all the treasure. Look at the shiny jewels! It won't advance the plot any. Okay, Dreza, I'd like you to give me a little bit of credit. It's like 12 minutes in there, and I haven't done a Yellow Wizard Harry thing yet.
Yeah, well, you have to give me credit. It's 12 minutes in, and I've only said woo twice.
Very good.
I don't need any credit for anything. I'm just here to watch DuckTales.
Hell yeah. Oh, Launchpad, you immense fuck-up.
Oh, Launchpad, falling off the edge and dying, being crushed by all the treasure. What a wacky guy.
You gotta love when a character's entire premise and reason for existing is to be a walking fuck-up.
It probably would have been a better idea if you brought multiple sacks.
But one sack makes it convenient.
Okay, so he's a wizard druid warlock with great strength.
Why isn't this guy the hero?
Exactly, this guy's badass.
You got his superpowers versus Scrooge's superpower of swimming in money.
They should totally make the Quack Avengers. I don't really think it's thieving, Scrooge, considering you took it first.
When I stole your treasure, I sounded just like this!
Oh, please, no! Oh, that is childhood nightmare fuel, please. The eyes.
Yeah, technically, you know, half of the characters in that movie were owned by Disney, so maybe for the next Disney fun.
See, this is the part that you can take of Scottish behaviour. Being a badass and fighting giant scorpions.
Witcher Kane?
We do that every week. It's like a social activity.
It's where the phrase square girl light came from.
Okay, Launchpad might be a dumbass, but he's got some strength behind him.
That's his whole purpose. That's why they bring him along. That and he can kind of fly a plane.
Scrooge is rich, so I imagine he doesn't want to fly his own plane, and he can't exactly get his nephews to do it.
Well, he could.
I don't get why he doesn't just hire a better pilot.
Because he is fond of Launchpad, because Launchpad is so stupid that he won't steal from him.
That actually seems like a really legitimate reason. He only hires Launchpad because he knows he won't take any of the treasure.
Yeah.
That's genius. Wow. Way to go, Drazer.
It's in the other movie, sir. We should try Aladdin.
Watch out, this bit. PPP, pathetic pit pocket. Kaka!
The transformation animation's pretty good, though.
Yeah. And it's a flash of emerald green light, so you can't go wrong there.
Yo, check out my sick bling!
Oh, how wacky!
We're about to go over a waterfall. Yep, shot rocks at the bottom. Yep, bring it on.
This totally won't lead to Disney World getting a water-based attraction in their park.
Maybe they should leave out the part where they try to drown the visitors.
No, that's essential to the ride, Tom. You have to have authenticity in these rides.
It's the integrity of the ride.
The animation is just like, back to normal now. They took a bus from Movieville back to Seriesville.
Scrooge is just like, oh no. Now I have to go home and see how my big pile of money doesn't get any bigger.
Damn. He's gonna go home and eat sad haggis.
So you mean haggis then?
Aw, thanks, Webby! Thanks for nothing!
Maybe I could make some pissing tea with it.
Scrooge, could you even live another 40 years?
He could live another 1,000 years, Scrooge McDuck.
Yeah. He can pay for a longer life.
I don't need to exaggerate how badass he is. Read the comics, it's all there, and it's all canon as well. Damn, Christopher Lloyd's got a good voice for villains.
Murlock was smart. He would have gathered all the treasure and traded Scrooge for the lamp.
Huh.
On the assumption that Scrooge doesn't already know the lamp is magical.
Yo, what's up, Granny from Looney Tunes?
It'd be funny if Scrooge just like picked up his phone and it got through to his secretary, but the secretary wasn't in when he says that.
Remember this is the Sylvester and Tweety Mistress?
Yes! I remember it specifically because of one scene where Tweety goes to a bathroom, and he goes into the male bathroom, and he pokes his head out like, see? I am a boy! That validated the entire series.
This whole commentary is just going to be like a nostalgic flashback to old cartoons.
Sell my lunch!
Scrooge McDuck's mansion was, like, so enticing to me as a kid. Like, I wouldn't even want to live there. Just visiting would be nice. Excuse me, Mum, I'm trying to brush up on being a stereotype. Do you know where the tea is?
This movie needs more stereotypes. That was their catchphrase.
Like, I should mention that we're watching this with subtitles that aren't synced to the movie.
Well, Mexican jumping bean, there's another one. Can we just keep a stereotype tally of this movie? Ugh.
Shibui.
Why does he have to be a duck?
Because everyone's either a duck or a dog.
It's called Ducktales, after all, not Human Tales.
Human Tales.
Hey, hey.
Getting a job and working for a living.
Hey, hey. Hey. Okay, Maxie, do you know who voices the genie?
Yeah, it's Rip Taylor.
Yeah, what else did he voice?
He actually doesn't do a lot of voice work. He's played himself more times than he's played characters.
Right.
And it's mostly just because he's a comedian with a really cool voice. The blender has a money symbol.
Yeah, it's pretty much like trademark in this world.
It's kind of like his signature. I'm going to put a dollar sign on here to show that it's mine.
It's mine. It was expensive. I own it. Deal with it.
See, he gets into a lot of trouble with banks because robbers come in with dollar signs on them. They're just like, that fucking Scrooge hired his cronies again.
Why don't you just hire Gilbert Gottfried if you want someone really shrill and annoying?
Because Rip Taylor, man.
Hilarious.
Get it? Because people in the past thought it was flat when it's actually an obloid spheroid.
Yeah, bitch, you're our slave now.
Yeah, we saw it in the script and the contract.
Three wishes for every master.
That's like 12 right there.
Sweet.
little pause so I can just figure out how many wishes it is.
Congratulations, Tom. Your arithmetic skills are unrivaled.
Hells yeah.
So if you and like 20 of your friends all found this magic lamp, totaling out 21 of you, 63 wishes?
Love that line. We should wish for happiness. Get that. And of course, Webigail goes and ruins her wishes. Look what you did! I wanted a rhino!
It would have been amazing if Dumbo was there. Just like a random cameo, they don't even address it.
That would have been cool.
The bigger the wish, the bigger the trouble. What if you wish for world hunger? Sorry. Cure world hunger.
I wish everyone in the world had no food! You dick!
That's amazing. Well, it's not amazing. It's diabolical is what it is. Amazingly diabolical.
I wish for world hunger.
I wish for world war. Just reverse wishes. Hijinks ensue. Ducktales, the movie. See if you can guess the cliches, guys. Coming up next, they're gonna hide the genie from Scrooge.
Guys, you broke Mrs. Bleakley.
Fuck Mrs. Bleakley, the library is what needs fixing.
Not the books! Oh no. Best wish ever.
Poof.
So he can reverse time with wishes?
No, he's simply reversing the wish, so everything that the elephant calls to happen reverses. Yeah, batshit insane, actually.
I don't think you're crazy, I just think you're past your sell-by date.
It's kind of weird that he mentions vacation time, because when she applied for the job to be his nanny, both her and Webigail were homeless, and she agreed to work, but by only being paid in food and home. So that's why Scrooge hired her, because he wouldn't have to pay her in money.
We're not fucking with the time-space continuum or anything.
She has a doll of herself.
We're just breaking her mind. She will become our slave. Ours. Nah, it's a bit late for me to be bringing this up now, but that's Russie Taylor as Huey, Dewey, and Louie, I believe.
Correct.
And that is also the voice of Minnie Mouse.
Wasn't she married to the guy who did Mickey Mouse's voice?
Wayne Allwine. Rest in peace. I can't watch the ending of Kingdom Hearts now without getting sad.
I learned the word ditto from this movie.
Not from Pokemon?
Nope, I had to ask my parents, why did he say ditto? What does that mean?
Same as before. Maybe something similar happened in Richie Rich.
A duck wished for a way to fly.
How very meta.
I'm assuming they didn't wish for this stuff.
They wished for some of it.
You're not too hungry, because what's coming up next is very visually appealing.
Oh, baby. Ice cream rain! Yay!
It's diabetes from the sky.
Giant maraschino cherries come as well.
Okay, I don't think they could eat even one of those balls by themselves. And he wished not too big.
I was gonna say, yeah, he wished for the biggest, and that was all they got? Pretty sure they could have gone a little bit bigger.
He could have got, like, a huge tower of ice cream, like Jack and the Beanstalk.
I want the Mount Everest of Sundays! I want the Saturn of Sundays.
Do you know what would be the worst of it? The best ice cream is at the very top.
Aww, that's evil.
That makes it worthwhile. Who are you and what have you done with the real Scrooge McDuck?
He's been brainwashed with magic! Because that's ethical and everything.
Well, that's bullshit. The Scrooge I know would be able to resist that kind of thing.
Scrooge I know would punch a genie in the face and still get his wishes.
Right in the face. Between the eyes. Open palmed. Keep going if you want.
We just have to emphasize that Scrooge McDuck is the badass. Not just A, he's the badass.
You kind of have to bring up the paradox of them wearing nightshirts when they don't wear anything on the bottoms.
Ducks don't wear pants, guys.
There is a reason why they don't wear pants, but I'd rather not share it.
It's because pants are uncomfortable, guys. Come on.
Does it have anything to do with anatomically correct Ducktales?
Yeah. Well, more to do with the song Scientifically Accurate Ducktales.
There we go. Okay, so he's a wizard, he's a warlock, he's a sorcerer, he's really strong.
And a druid.
Yeah, and a druid. He's got one impressive resume, actually.
Most broken D&D character I've ever heard of.
And he's immortal!
What? It's like, that's not even a character, that's a fucking super boss.
Character development intensifies. Oh, it's little Cleo from Pinocchio. It's probably not, but still. You know, when House of Mouse first came out, that blew my fucking mind. I remember, like, watching the premiere of it on the Disney Channel.
See? Don't have the genie give you infinite wishes. Wish for an item that then gives you infinite wishes.
You see, if Aladdin had thought of that loophole, that movie would have been over really quickly.
My god, that's a brilliant idea. Why do they just not wish to have the talisman?
I wish he was dead.
But they just established he was immortal.
I wish he was no longer immortal and would then drop dead.
Okay, we have two wishes left. Number one, bring the talisman to us. Number two, lock him in the center of the earth.
He also has apparently different versions of bird form.
I agree with you, Mexi. That is some good animation, even though it's like dropped a tad in this part of the movie.
It's still nice.
Like for a television like movie, it's really good still.
Kill? This is a Disney film.
There's no death.
You only kill if you're a villain or Simba. So he can also not only turn to an eagle, he can turn to a rat?
Anything. He can turn into anything he wants.
Okay, that's not druid magic, that's just plain good metamorphosis. This guy, it's like, people talk of the like most powerful Disney villains. This guy is up there.
Put Murloc in Kingdom Hearts 3.
Seriously, do it. No, wait for the next saga. So, like, where everything restarts and the worlds are just, like, kind of light in tone. And you can, like, have a DuckTales world.
Genie has been reduced to nothing more than a pet. He's in the house now. He doesn't have to be in rat form no more. And if he gets caught, he can just make the ducks blow up.
Exactly.
Look, Launchpad's an idiot. Why don't you just tell him to screw off?
You can't do that to Launchpad.
Yeah, you can if you're Scrooge McDuck.
Then he'll call Darkwing Duck to kick your ass.
But what if Scrooge is Darkwing Duck?
He's not. Let's just put that out there right now.
Okay. When there's trouble, you call DW.
When you say that, I think of Arthur's sister.
I thought I was the only one. Mrs. Beakley, confirmed OP, please nerf.
Yeah, we have the mighty wizard, warlock, sorcerer, druid. Then we have Mrs. Beakley.
It's like a clear cut-off line.
She was raised on the streets, fool. She's not taking any of your shit.
I want a doll that looks like me.
It's called voodoo.
Yeah, I was going to say, I'm sure other people would want one too, but they can't have one, just me.
So Tom, when is the official line of HFC action figures coming out?
Maybe when we're actually successful.
Can I have Kung Fu Grip?
I give you a fucking Kung Fu Grip.
I want Karate Chop action! Webby, what is with you and making the worst wishes ever?
That tiger, holy shit!
Even the roller skate's alive!
This is terrifying, and we watched Return to Oz. Oops, there's another one.
Dude, Beakley is off the hinges now!
That's a terrifying picture about there. Do you see that?
What? Do you see that statue?
Jumanji!
Oh no! Mrs. Beakley's gonna need extra therapy for this.
Wackity schmackity doo.
That derp tiger.
Did you like a sorcerer warlock? You can't stand up to a tiger.
Rat form is his poor form. He loses all of his OP abilities.
He doesn't have the powers to cast in druid form.
Casting rat form, he's in cooldown for all his other abilities.
Oh well, I'll just go put on like one of my other several billion hats.
No, that hat got him money.
You do not understand the millions of dollars that was poured into that hat.
Look how many animation frames that hat has. The silk sheen to it, it's gotta be worth a bob or two.
I like how we spent half of this commentary talking about how badass Scrooge is, yet he just got bested by a hat.
No, this is how he got his fortune, being this smooth.
This is actually how rich people get dressed, actually. you wouldn't know, you're not high class.
Damn.
Yeah, but Wallace and Gromit do it in a similar way. What are you trying to say?
Oh, they're actually mint, you just didn't know it.
That's how he supplies his cheese fixation.
That's what I was going to say.
Smashing cheese, Gromit.
And now Scrooge is going crazy. I like how Scrooge asks this stuff when shit like this happens in every single episode. You'd think after a while he would just catch on.
I made a really stupid wish and now we can't take it back, so can you use one of your wishes instead?
All of Huey's wishes are just gonna end up being retcon wishes. That poor guy. Webby made a stupid wish. Again, that's what happened, Uncle Scrooge.
Okay, I can't remember, like, which duck is which.
Huey is red, Dewey is blue, Louie is green.
Huey's wearing a robber mask, but he's in a police car.
Because he stole the police car.
That's some Grand Theft Auto shit right there.
I think you mean Grand Duck Auto.
Grand Duck Auto 6 better take place in Duckburg, or I am writing an angry letter to Rockstar.
Grand Duck Auto starring Scrooge McFuck yourself.
Bless me, bagpipes!
Oh no, Scrooge has gone diamond crazy.
See, this is why Scrooge isn't allowed to play Minecraft.
He would just make a mod and just have everything below the first layer of the earth be diamond.
Yes, exactly.
The trees are diamond, the lake is diamond, the sky is diamond.
Forget the treasure, I got the lamp, fools.
I'm so sorry, Trace, I'm so sorry. You better believe I'm reveling in the shiny green gems. Better believe it.
If I had that magic lamp, I'd probably wish for the same thing.
I would wish for the money in the vault.
I'd wish for all the money.
In every vault.
I wish every country was in debt to me.
Genius! These are some civil rights issues being addressed in this movie, guys.
And off he saunters to go to a high-class party, not giving a jot about the working class.
He just called a person a thing, and now he's going to a richy-rich party. Wow, Scrooge, you're way more stereotypes than I give you credit for.
I'm still here!
Not even money can stand up to Murloc. Watch Murloc accidentally get sucked into the propeller blades.
Vroom. What would rich people even do at a party for rich people? Discuss how rich they are.
What else is there to talk about?
How many billions did you make this week? Oh, I made trillions, actually.
Ooh, impressive.
My name is The Gaming Brit, and I purchased the Metroid franchise.
And while everyone's socializing, talking about how rich they are, there's just Scrooge in the corner, talking to his really fancy teapot.
Who even invited him?
Okay, I have to ask, is Murloc a animorph? Just giving me those vibes right now.
Well, he's a druid. Druids, they tend to just turn into different animals.
If he could turn into anything other than animals, I'm pretty sure he would turn into an Apache helicopter and just shoot down the building to get the genie.
That scene would play out really differently if so. What's that noise? Okay, yeah, soda.
Well, Tom, champagne is for grown-ups.
I noticed one of the ducks there had goggles around his neck. It's like, is this rich people fashion?
It's actually the Explorers Club, which, yeah, is pretty much still just rich people.
Mexi with the actual info.
Oh, baby, it's like I have Wikipedia open.
He didn't even shut the door behind him.
Okay, there's Kleptomania, and then there's Dijon.
What not to do in Skyrim, part one.
And now I would like to introduce the richest explorer among all of us. He's very stingy, don't ask for handouts. You're all fucking stupid, and I'm the richest one here.
There was the Indiana Jones dog.
Yeah, the title screen uses the same font as Raiders of the Lost Ark, so they decided to throw in an Indiana cameo.
Pigs. Why'd it have to be pigs?
I'm honestly surprised that there are pigs in a universe that is 50% ducks, 50% dogs.
Well, they exist in Life and Times of Scrooge McDuck, I can tell you that much. Yeah, I know how to walk upstairs, thanks.
Well, when you're so rich, you have people do things for you, so sometimes you don't know these things.
Tough question.
Just mulls it over for a second.
Besides, I'm pretty sure Scrooge McDuck absorbs life force from money. That's why he's always swimming in it.
The more money he has, the more power he has.
Thus making him the most powerful duck in the world.
I guess the genie couldn't bear to see him die.
Shut the fuck up.
I like how no one else from the party downstairs is even remotely questioning. Like, no one hears this? At all?
The rich are completely different to you and I, Mexi. No offense. Oh, his pantaloons are on show. This is comedic.
Oh, such rich, classy humor.
Excuse me while I waddle away.
There's actually nothing in his pants, those are just a new style.
Did he pick up an ashtray? That couldn't have been an ashtray, actually, it's a Disney film.
Nice acoustics in there.
Sing the DuckTales theme while in the lamp.
Don't you dare.
Typical bucket on the foot.
Man, this movie's just ticking all the comedy cliches. What's next? There'll be like a mix-up and Scrooge will take the wrong lamp by accident. Well, actually, I did, but I'm just going to gloss over that fact.
Oh, quiet, guys. Genie's having a moment.
Scrooge don't give a shit.
How could this happen to me?
He's too rich for emotions.
Now get in the fucking Pokeball.
Rich people don't have buddies. That's what money's for.
I just want to point out the worrying implications of Scrooge being an actual slave owner now.
Don't say that. This is a Disney film.
Nice.
More like Smooth McDuck.
Oh. Hey Tom, that's that cliche you were talking about.
Oh wow, I'm so prophetic. Get ready for a really creepy face. Ah!
I really want to just caption the look on both of their faces.
What is this? You're neither rich nor Scottish.
Oh, I could take that out of context, and I will.
He wants other things so badly, too.
That's what the genie's for.
That's gotta be cold on the old duck feet there.
Shoes don't exist in this world.
Watch how fast this helicopter gets away, by the way.
Oh no, he got a helicopter! Quick, turn into something that can't fly!
Yes, a land-based animal. Look, I can't even see it anymore, it's gone!
Tom, that's the power of money.
Runs on money.
I'm sorry, last I checked, Scrooge McDuck doesn't start with a D.
But he's a duck. He owns the race of ducks.
Cut to Dijon being swagtacular. Oh my god, all that money just turned him into even more of a stereotype. It's kind of sad, really.
Wait, did he say good morning? Surely it's, like, nighttime, because they just went to a party and he's just come back.
He's so rich, he can pay people to lie about the time of day to him.
Why, yes, sir, it is morning. Good morning to you, too.
He's got a salt emerald in his turban.
I love how the cop standing in front of the police car was a pig.
Yep.
Yep, so he was.
How did you not notice that?
Even if it was Scrooge's name, it would just be an S. That could mean anybody.
This is where Santa keeps all his money. How do you think he buys all those toys?
Santa don't make fucking PS4s. So the birds are just sitting in the cold, not going to fly in the prison for shelter.
It's because they're fat pigeons, and they're afraid Scrooge is going to eat them.
And look at it this way, son. We're richer than Scrooge McDuck right now.
Ouch! Scrooge ain't having none of your Disney magic tears.
Well, they just worked.
Launch padded from the side.
Because obviously Scrooge is just too manly to cry, so instead of giving him the power of Disney tears, it was Disney drops.
Oh my god, launch pad, what are you doing?
He's checking this out.
He's just giving this pose as if he's just like saved them all.
He only paid us like a quarter every other month, but it's gotta mean something, right?
Mrs. Beakley, why are you upset? You've been homeless before, you know how to handle this, you come from the streets, girl!
No, not McDuck Mansion.
Our beautiful home? Since when did she own any of it?
She lives in it. She takes care of it. That's just the look of a man has right before he's about to snap and just kill everybody.
14,657, I'd like to remind you. And he remembers all of them.
Scrooge is pretty savvy.
That's the key to making shit tons of money, is having good memory.
Something tells me we should break into the mansion. I believe it's the script, but I'm not sure.
Holy crap, the stereotype meter! It's burning up!
Excuse me while I drink this bubbling gravy.
Looming, one of Murloc's many powerful skills.
His other one is getting a windowsill! Wait, never mind. I don't know why he turned into a cockroach. He could have wormed his way in there.
Fucking tracer.
I learned from the best, Tom.
Thank you. I'm right here, boys. You don't need to do that.
Commander Beakley.
You kids are stupid. They're gonna be looking for ducks in camouflage. No one's out here looking for a nanny.
No one expects the nanny.
Sick halo jump there, Scrooge, my boy.
Just gotta circle the D a few times and then land.
They're quick. Like, that was really quick running.
This is choreographed to the letter, mate.
They planned all of it out with the woodchuck guidebook. The password was cash.
And Dijon didn't bother to change it?
Dijon is many things, but a smart man is not one of them. The floor is lava.
No, the black squares are lava.
No, seriously, you step on them, they'll turn into actual lava. Scrooge ain't fucking around.
Scrooge don't fuck when it comes to money.
So in case you wanted to make Scrooge look even more Scottish, here's a nice beret.
I'm surprised his parachute wasn't tartan coloured.
Why do they still have leaves? They're not outside anymore.
They're trying to blend into the white walls. So this is where the animation budget went to at the end of the film.
Yeah.
Okay, is that one Louis?
Yep.
Okay, well, Louis, there's this thing called timing when it comes to lasers.
Looks like he's got it down. Nope, nope.
That's okay, you can live through a nuclear blast, you're gonna be fine.
Head chopped off, good. Nuclear blast, good. Cockroaches are, like, the most scary insect on Earth.
He's probably invested, like, a lot of money into his security to have it disabled by marbles.
Wow, he was using his nephews and niece to test out the security system.
That cane! Just fucking snaps the door open.
Play the Ducktales game on the NES.
Oh yes, the cane that kills everything. Turn into something else. Is he honestly this stupid? Come on.
All powerful, yet lacking in the brain department.
Common sense is what he likes.
I mean, he did turn into a tiger to stop a helicopter.
It was more of a cougar, really, but yeah.
Let go, Scrooge. Let go!
Crunch! Cut to credits.
Ooh, DuckTales got darker than I imagined. Didn't remember it.
DuckTales!
Woohoo!
Big Bad's dead.
Why don't you just wish the lamp to a secure location? One that only you can access.
Like the vault. Or you could just go put it there.
That was the original plan.
Surprise!
Should have done that sooner! Yes, more wishes!
All of the wishes!
Bibbidi bobbidi bang!
Just in case you weren't paying attention to the earlier parts of the movie.
I'll teach you to be a stereotype in this movie!
How dare you do what I was doing and act selfishly!
There's your pig.
That's really bad, considering what his religion could very well be.
This blew my mind when I first watched it.
I want a fortress more fitting for me, it turns into a bouncy castle.
Yay!
Excuse me, I think you mean a bounce room. A moon jump. Oh, the floor is lava.
Ah, there we go.
No, not the vault.
My money. Ew, the building just grew gross teeth. Ew. They told me to take the stairs in case of an emergency! This was supposed to help! The stairs are now a dragon?
So, can we have this ride at Disneyland?
They tried it out once. It was rated too extreme.
So they just replaced it with more people in costumes for you to hug and take pictures with?
I don't see how this is better than the bin, personally.
Well, you see, it's kind of subtle. You can't really tell so much that it's evil.
Yeah, okay.
That Christopher Lloyd evil laugh, it's so good.
Now we're like 7 minutes away from the end of the film here, so hopefully there's gonna be some climactic showdown.
It's DuckTales. Something's gonna happen. The worst of messes are gonna become successes.
Shut up.
This kind of begs the question, how did this guy lose the lamp in the first place?
It got mixed up. So when's the part where the giant serpent comes and eats everything? because I am getting serious Aladdin vibes. Return the lamp before I shove this cane up your ass!
Trust me, you would not want this cane up your ass.
Scrooge, you may be able to bounce on things, but now I am going to bounce on you!
If only he'd actually threatened him with the cane, and then the bad guy just wished to have Scrooge's cane?
Plot over. The end. GG.
I don't like it, but I understand. Why didn't you just wish for a gun?
Disney, man. We're in space!
Okay, so why is there still gravity?
Why is there still air?
Murloc's a dumbass.
These kids can outsmart anyone and anything in existence. His ultimate form!
A griffin!
You know, you could have killed them then and there, but I suppose going back for them is a good idea as well.
It's not like the lamp's going anywhere. Hell, if you just let Scrooge fall, he probably would have died.
Kane powers activate!
Okay, so Scrooge is falling hundreds of feet to his doom, and he doesn't give a fuck.
He's Scrooge. McDuck.
The rich fuck. I laugh if he was falling so fast they didn't get a chance to finish the wish.
And we all lived happily ever, splat!
I wish everything was back to normal. Oh, but Murloc dies.
I also like how he specified right now, it's like, have that wish done in about 5 more minutes. I think I won't be dead by then.
Well, you have to specify. He did say big wishes usually end up going wrong, so he wants to be very specific. No technicalities with this one.
Ah, sweet, sweet capitalism.
He's so shiny.
I haven't really mentioned him throughout the course of this movie, but it wouldn't really be the same without him. Props to Alan Young for voicing Scrooge in this, and in general, really.
Yep, all these guys came back for DuckTales Remastered. Just shows how amazing this cast is.
They sound a little bit tired, though, if I'm honest.
20 years after doing a voice, can you really expect them to be exactly the same?
No, but it is appreciated.
Pulling Aladdin.
Gee, I wish you free! And for you to be voiced by Robin Williams.
It's like last minute change, he just suddenly starts talking like Robin Williams. And then Dan Castellaneta. And then Robin Williams again. Oh my god, they Pinocchio'd the plot!
Yeah, we were going Aladdin, and then that's the biggest plot twist of the whole movie!
Ducktail swerve!
Magic gravy power!
Totally 90s, dude.
He looks old for a duck.
And now we're gonna adopt you like we did Webby. Seriously, Scrooge has way too many kids for his old age.
Well, he's just preparing future heirs to run his businesses.
Yeah, but does he not worry about how much this costs him?
It's not like he's gonna give them any of the money. Now what are we gonna put our tea in?
You could always, like, take the remains and melt it down.
It was gold at one point.
Get off me and never mention this incident again. Scrooge looked really weird for a second, though.
You're a sweet kid. It's gonna be fun putting you in the orphanage.
And this character was never heard from again.
That impression.
He pulled a kind of a Daffy Duck there with his head round the corner.
Quadzillionaires.
Try calculating that shit, you'll be here all year.
So many zeros.
So, we're at the end of the movie now. Mexi, what did you think?
It's DuckTales. Of course I love it.
Drazer?
Woo!
And what else needs to be said, really? Thanks all for listening. We'll see you all tomorrow for another DisneyFon commentary. See you then.